On a un besoin de stabilité et de retrouver ses racines.
Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Today I have a video that will help you guys find out what your undertone is. So we have cool, neutral and warm undertone, and which one are you? So today we'll find out. So to give you guys a better understanding of what is warm and what is cool, I have some colors that I'm gonna include here to show you guys. So usually for your warm tones, you have more of like your reddish colors, your oranges, your corals, whereas for your cool tones, you have a little bit more of like the purples and the pinks and the blues in them. So I've learned some simple tests to find out what undertone you are. Personally for me, after like trying out so many different makeup styles, makeup tones, clothes and everything, I realized that I'm a neutral warm. So first test is the veins test. You want to look at your veins, especially around like your arm area, like underneath at your wrist area. Are they greenish? Are they yellowish? Or are they bluish and purplish? So if you are greenish and yellowish, you are more likely to be warm. And if you are bluish, purplish, you're more likely to be cool. But if you look at it and you still can't figure out which side you are, you're most likely neutral. And for people with neutral skin tones, you can go both warm or cool colors. So for me, I don't know if you guys can see, but my veins are a little bit weird because my right hand looks a little bit more like warmer, like greenish, but then my left hand looks a little bit more like purplish blue. So I would say I am literally a mix of both. What does it mean if I have a warm undertone? Well, it simply means that warm colors would suit you much better than cool colors. And how will this help me? So, personally for me, I feel like it's quite important to know what undertone you are so that when you choose your makeup products, you would go for something that is more suitable for your skin undertone. Even your makeup, your hair color, your contact lens color, your lip color, right down to your clothes and your shoes and your bags. All these really, really matter. So to help you guys see visually, I'm gonna show you guys examples. I'm gonna apply one side using warm tone makeup and one side using cool tone makeup. So I've got two palettes examples for you guys. I have here my Naked Heat palette from Urban Decay. This one is very obviously warm tone. As you can see, the colors are mostly towards your reddish, orangey, even the browns are like kind of brick brown color. On the cooler side, I have my Milani Soft and Sultry palette. Over here, we have really your neutral and a lot of cool tones. So I know it's not the best or the fairest comparison between the both. I don't really have an orangey eyeshadow palette that is cool tone, so this is the best I can find. Okay, I'm gonna go in with black eyeliner on both eyes to make sure everything is fair. And I chose black because usually black is very neutral. Okay, so I think the difference is very obvious. This side I use more of an orangey coral color and this side is more smokier, I guess more grayish. I'm gonna cover one side to give you guys a comparison. So typically people with warmer undertones would look better in kind of like these kind of shades. And people with cooler undertones will look nicer in like your grays. And even if you choose to go for a smoky eye, people with warmer undertones should go for something a little bit more like coppers, you know, go for your burnt browns, your oranges, kind of smoky eye. Whereas for people with cool undertones, gray smoky eyes, silver smoky eyes, or metallic gunmetal colors would suit you better. I'm gonna complete the rest of my face and I will see you guys at the lipstick step. All right, it's now time for the lipstick. I have a cool tone lipstick over here. This one is the Benefit Kissing Color Balm in the shade 66 Fuchsia. So I'm just gonna put them side by side on my hand, then I can show y'all what it means by cool and warm. So for the warm tone, I'm using this one, the Hera Spicy Nude Volume Matte. This one is in the shade 173 in Sour Tomato. Here it is. this is cool, and this is warm. It's quite obvious, right? All right, and there we have it. Warm tone, cool tone. The next test to test whether or not you are warm tone or cool tone is by using jewelry. So I have a set of gold and silver jewelry to just demonstrate it to you guys. So silver jewelry will typically look better on people with a cooler skin tone compared to this side. Whereas gold jewelry will look better on people with warmer skin tones as compared to the other side. Right? But of course, if you're neutral, then the best would be rose gold jewelry because it can fit both cool tones and warm tones as well. Okay, I'm gonna switch up my earrings because the previous one was a bit too small. I thought I should give you guys a clearer comparison. All right, the next test would be outfits. So I have here two examples of greens. This one is obviously very, very, very cool tone, whereas this one is more of like an olive green with a little bit of warm tones inside. As you can see, it's also paired with gold jewelry. So if I were to use this makeup and wear this, it is kind of mismatch, isn't it? So this outfit would look much better with this makeup look. On the other hand, if I use something really cool tone and try to match it with my warm tone makeup look, it just looks a little bit weird and a little bit like just not ideal. So if I were to do it cool tone, if you guys can see, I think the entire like makeup look matches better, like with the lipstick, the eyeshadow, and the outfit. But that's not to say that you can't mix and match, you know, however you want. It's really, really up to you. The purpose of this video is to help you guys kind of discover what your undertone is. Personally for me, after discovering that I'm more towards the warmer side, everything just kind of made more sense. And I have also made more like conscious decisions when it came to buying like makeup products or matching my colors with my clothes and stuff like that. So I hope this video was helpful for you guys. And if you did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Talk to me in the comments box down below and let me know what your undertone is. Of course, this is a super simple, super straightforward, very elementary level kind of video in discovering what your skin undertone is. If you search it up online, there are a ton of services that can help you better and more accurately decide, like determine what is your skin undertone. And there are a lot more tests out there that you can do as well. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And if you did, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next one. Bye. Thank you.